Yo, what's going on, guys? Tempo here. In this video, I'll be teaching you guys on how to add annotations in your videos or how to add end screen annotations. So this has been requested so much, and finally I'm going to be making the video. Sorry for the background noise right there. So yeah, let's get right into this. So first we're going to open your Google Chrome or whatever browser you're on. Also guys, if you could leave a like, because I'm recording in 2K resolution now. I'm upgrading to a new PC soon, in about a week time. So it's going to be a Nvidia graphics card one, so it's going to be pretty nice. A £1,000 one, so it should be pretty good for the money. So yeah, first of all, you want to click on your icon up here. You want to click on that, and then you're going to click on Create a Studio. And then after you click on that, it should bring you to a page like this. After you do that, you want to click on this video manager button here. So it should bring you to a page like this, or if it doesn't bring you to a page like this and you're watching this video in like a couple of years time, yeah, just make sure you're on videos, and yeah, it should look similar to this, like where it comes up with your likes, comments, views and all that stuff. Like this comes up with your videos basically. So yeah, now what you want to do is you can just click on edit. So I'm going to click on edit right now. So wait for everything to load up after you've clicked on that button, and it should come up to a page like this. As I did say, if you're watching this later, it should come up to something similar. So I'm just going to click on end screen and annotations right there. As you can see, this little button up here. So end screen annotation is, as I did say, it's for popular YouTubers. They all use it. KSI uses it. PewDiePie uses it. At the end of the video, it shows like their logo, and then when you click on their logo, it makes you subscribe, or if there's a video there, it plays a video and gives a link to the video. So it's really, really, really amazing. So you can import a video, use the template, and yeah, all that good stuff. So you can click on preview and it show you what it's like. So I'm just gonna click on add element, this blue link here, and it should come up with video or playlist, subscribe, channel, link. So the link I'm not going to be doing in this video. So yeah, what I'm going to be doing is putting in a subscribe. So yeah, I'm going to go to the last 10 seconds of my video. So 4:35, that's what you got to do. Just click on that bit there, then click on that again. I'm going to create the subscribe button. And as you can see, it comes up with this thing like here. You can move it anywhere you want, like over there. So I'm just going to pull it up there, right here, the top right. And it only lets you have this section here, which I think they should just let you have the whole section, but it might just be to the guidelines or something, I don't know. But yeah, you can also edit this, like you can put it to the start of the video, you can put it to the end, and I'm going to be putting it to, as I did say, 4:35. So I just decrease it a little bit there. I'm going to add another element. This one is going to be a video or playlist. I'm going to put most recent upload. Then I'm going to create the element. And after you do that, there should be, I created my most recent upload. I'm going to show you some more in a minute. So I'm going to put that right next to that one there. Then I'm going to add another element whilst dragging up like that. So this element, now I'm going to put in you can put in someone else's channel if you're collabing with them in that video. So I'm just going to you can pull it up and down and that stuff, like you could do in Photoshop. So you're going to click on video or playlist again. And you're going to put best for viewer, so if it was a viewer that normally watches vlogs and you upload some vlogs sometimes, it's going to like, say if you use a tutorial channel and you like upload a setup tour, it would be like come up with the most recommended video for them. So it says allow YouTube to select a video from your channel to suit the best viewer. That's a pretty good description, so yeah, let that tell you what it is. So yeah, I'm going to click on that and then press create element. Sorry if I'm speaking too fast, guys. Comment down below if I am, if you're like, if you can't understand me, just tell me, because I do speak a little bit too fast. So I'm just going to place that down here in line with the other video. Now I'm going to add another element. This is going to be my last element because you can only put 4 in at a time. You can put them in different orders, so one goes before the other. So yeah, click on video playlist again. So click on create. Choose a video from a playlist. That's what I'm going to do right now. And you can just pick a video from any place you have. You can type in the URL or type in the video name. And I'm just going to put in one that they might want to watch. I'm going to put in top 3 ways to grow your YouTube channel. So I'm going to put that in. I think it's to grow as a designer or something. So yeah, create element right there. And it should say working, something like that. So yeah, I'm going to place this. And as you can see like the thumbnail. And it's going to be playing in the video. Like it's going to be like showing some of the video of me talking in it. So that's a really good way. So I'm just going to place that out the way up there and move this down. Move that down with it. I'm also going to put the logo right next to it like so. Like that. And it does look a little bit jumbled up, but you can just organise it in your time. So I'm just going to put that there. Put that down there. I'm just doing this off my top of my head so you can obviously organise it better. And yeah, I'll show you what it's going to look like, but it will look different when you watch it. So yeah, here you go. You won't hear the audio, I don't think you can, but yeah. Here you go, guys. I'm going to be quiet right now. That's how you make a free banner, guys. If you did enjoy this video, drop a like on this video. That'd be highly appreciated. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. So yeah, that was the video, guys. And before I do end this video, I'm going to save it real quick. And it should say a save button up here. It should say all changes have saved. If it does not say that, do not click off the annotation, or you have to do it again. Yeah, you can click on view, then change all that stuff. You can use a template. I might make a template soon, but they give you some like recommended ones. I think they should let you make a template and upload it. Pretty sure that'd be better. So yeah, they give you some templates right here. So before I end the video, I'm just going to show you if it like if this helps you. So I've only had it on this one video here, but I did just delete it right now so I could show you guys it works. So how you look if this is growing your channel, you're going to click on this analytics tab here, if I'm saying that right. So you're going to click on it, wait for it to load. It does take quite a bit to load because it has all your analytics up there, and it's the biggest tab here, like with all the biggest stuff in there. So after it's loaded up, you should see like loads of stuff here. And this is why it takes ages to load up. So you can see if you're growing from live streaming. You can see if you're growing with your subscribers, with your translations, like with the language stuff. And you can look at all this stuff. So I'm going to look at my end screens. And as you can see, it says new. So it's pretty new to the YouTube feature. So yeah, I'm going to click on that right here. Wait for it to load. And it should come up with something like if it grows your channel. And as you can see, it says end screen element. Someone's clicked on it 4 times yesterday, I think, today actually. So in this past 24 hours, 5 people have clicked on it. So that's pretty good, as I've only used it in one video, and that's probably got me, let's see, time range, yep. So end screen elements shown to 62 people, and end screen elements clicked 6. And clicks per end screen element shown, if I said that right, 9.68%. So as you can see, that has grown my channel by 6 people probably clicking on that video and subscribing to me. So it's a pretty easy way to grow your channel. And as you can see, it says clicks per end screen element shown, and in a different tab. I don't know what it is, but someone did say, I think it was Ali, so I'm leaking down below because I did steal this video off of him. Thank you, Ali Mod, if I'm saying that right, mode. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong, but yeah, guys. Thank you so much for letting me hit 800 subscribers at the moment of the recording this video. I hit 805. Q&A will be coming up soon, so stay tuned for that. Also, a thank you video will be coming up soon as well. Probably not a thank you video, because there's no point of them if I'm going to upload a Q&A. So yeah, guys, if you do want any videos, like a video that you're stuck with, or like if you can't grow your channel, tell me down below some video ideas, and I'll definitely make that in the next 48 hours. So yeah, guys, I'll see you in my next video. Please like, subscribe, and peace.